Tonight I learned, you go first, and you bring help. Mallory, that was a great job. I really did that. Okay. So it's getting a little bit... Step back, okay. How's this? Okay. So we have real working cowboys. Rodeo cowboys, not cowboys, actors that play cowboys on TV and the movies. And then we have unlikely cowboys like me. And unlikely cowboys and cowgirls happen because I believe there's a cowboy spirit that lives inside each and every one of us, just waiting for the right set of circumstances to bring it to life. For me, it was working cattle south of Shamrock back in the 90s, and the owner of the ranch gave me a Red Steagall cassette tape, and after I listened to that a few times, my thoughts and ideas about the West started coming to me in rhyme. Not long after that, I found myself in a restaurant and bar in Scottsdale, Arizona, by the name The Unlikely Cowboy. And I stole that. And as I sat in the bar there and studied the patrons, I began to imagine what it might be like if the cowboy spirit came to life in one of them. He was the unlikely type, caught up in the hype of living the businessman's way, heading home from the grind he pulled off to find a watering hole at the end of the day. When he'd found that bar door he'd not passed through before, he felt something draw him inside. The ambiance of the place hit him square in the face. He was in for a hell of a ride. He was struck by the gaze, through the smoke and the haze of the fellas lined up at the bar. With that first taste of beer, it was coming quite clear. This is not how things usually are. He was feeling uneasy. His stomach was queasy. He felt the room start to spin. He couldn't yet know, but fate would soon show a new life was about to begin. First, there's confusion caused by an illusion, the reflection that appears in your glass. You can no longer see who you used to be. A transition is coming to pass. It's a state of mind you'll eventually find that's lain dormant in your heart. For reasons not clear, your call came this year, and a cowboy becomes your part. You'll find yourself drawn from dusk until dawn to things that you've missed in the past, like the wide open sky and the coyote's cry, and how long sunsets last. You'll watch westerns all night till your mind takes flight to a place in some faraway trail where you live on a horse, charting a course to deliver your herd to the rail. Rock and roll bands drift away with the sands. Just don't get you tapping your feet, because the music you're hearing will have your truck steering to a dance hall with a country beat. The opposite sex will still seem complex, though blue jeans more fitting attire. For the love of your life, hope for your wife. A cowgirl is what you'll desire. A trip in your car to some sushi bar no longer brings satisfaction. It's an extended cab truck to where the Bronx buck, and bull riding's the main attraction. Your wardrobe will morph, the jeans section will dwarf what used to be tailor-made suits, and you'll need a wide brim when the sun's not so dim, and you'll feel most at home in your boots. As the changes take place, you give up the rat race, cash it in, find your place in the sun, and get used to the feel of no concrete and steel, and you'll sense that your journey's begun. Finding wide open spaces and secluded places that reveal what life's all about. What's been held back for years can sometimes bring tears that wash away remaining doubt. What's happened is real. You can't conceal the true feelings that churn in your gut. Of a carol's been born who never will mourn what was when the door slammed shut. So my friends, beware of this story I share about someone who wandered in to enjoy a drink or cold brew without having a clue. They'd be the next unlikely cowboy. Thank you. evening twilight, melancholy shadows stray down the trail of memories far west of yesterday. And the night times were dreaming of the days of long ago, to the time of the cowboy and a horse is what I rode. Oh, I'd ride across the open range under skies of blue, down dusty trails of sand and sage. It seems so real and so true that dreams don't last forever, but my thoughts, they never die. Out west of yesterday, in my dreams I always ride. Sun's a-dancing along the mountain crest. Coyote choir's a-singing, showing off its best. And the life of a cowboy was not my destiny, but this cowboy spirit lives inside of me. When I ride across the open range under skies of blue, down dusty trails of sand and sage, it seems so real and so true that dreams don't last forever, but my thoughts, they never die. Out west of yesterday, in my dreams I always ride. Out west of yesterday, in my dreams I always ride. Out west of yesterday. Okay. So, what's that back there? Okay. The first place that my wife Marilyn and I built here was located west of Oklahoma City and just north of the town of Yukon. And the place that we built on was located on part of the old Chisholm Cattle Trail. And we know that's true because there was a concrete monument on the south and east sides of the section, and on the line straight between those is where you'd find our place. And many were the evening that I would sit out in the patio and think about what it must have been like for the cowboys moving cattle up the Chisholm to the railheads in Kansas. And on one particular evening, as the sun was setting, the wind lay down to nothing at all when I heard it. A whisper on the night wind along the Chisholm Trail. The ghost of those men born to roam, who'd speak of cattle and cowboys in rich and rugged detail, who never knew of family, farm, or home, but lives where days are measured in miles gained and cattle lost. The reward was freedom for their soul. Nature called the cadence with turning leaves and morning frost, counting the days until they reached their goal. There's a roaring of the south wind, fed by the autumn sun, the prairie floor of furnace like a smithy shop, soaked in sweat and caked in dust on a journey that's half done, melts the steel of lesser men, begging them to stop. Perched in their saddles, they push on, caught in the prairie's trance, their weathered faces hide beneath the brim, and dream of things many miles away, lost in the dust devil's dance, riding towards the shadow of the mesa's rim. There's chaos in the current as the river starts to swell. Fear casts its spell among the herd. The rising waters threaten to carry them to hell. sounds of prayer without a spoken word. The riverbank moves swiftly by as they fight for the other side. Muscles muster all that they can stand. Swimming against the devil's grip, they continue on this ride. Weary limbs find comfort in the sand. There's a rhythm to the movement of the herd and ebb and flow, a churning sea of hide and horn that takes on a life of its own with man and horse in tow. A giant they awake each morn who measures out the distance from first light until dark, the pace set by the task at hand. It seems some days of this journey yet no closer to the mark, adrift out here on an endless land. There's a joy that fills the night air as a starlight casts its spell. Rugged faces gather round the fire to sing the songs and hear the stories that the journeymen tell, above the chorus of the coyote choir. Then they wrestle the ground in hopes of drifting off to sleep, escaping from the trials of the trail, then start again at morning light, this schedule that they keep, each day moving closer to the rail. There's a sadness to their calling, as if somehow they know their fate, it has been cast, and all that will survive this life is the prairie wind to blow as they ride into the past. And sometimes, on a quiet eve, you might feel their presence near. As you look into the night sky above and see the ghost of days gone by, quietly shed a tear for the passing of this life they love. Well, I'm weary and tired. I've done my day's riding. Nighttime, she's rolling my way. And the sky's all on fire, and the night's slowly fading, peaceful and still in the day. And up on the trail, night birds are calling, singing their wild melody. And down in the canyon, cottonwoods whisper a song of Oklahoma for me. Well, I've wandered around the towns and the cities, trying to figure the how and the why. Oh, I've stopped all my scheming, I'm just drifting and dreaming, watching the river roll by. And here comes that big old prairie moon rising, shining down bright as can be. And up on a hill, a coyote singing a song of Oklahoma for me. Well, it's whiskey and tobacco and bitter black coffee, a lonesome old dogie of mine. But riding up on the range, Lord, I feel like an angel, feel like I almost could fly. And drift like a cloud over the badlands, sing like a bird in the trees. And the wind in the sage sounds like heaven singing a song of Oklahoma for me. A song of Oklahoma for me. A song of Oklahoma for me. Thank you. So can somebody tell me what the main event is at the rodeo? Right. It's the only event at the rodeo that has nothing to do with cowboy and cowgirl skills. And I don't know if anybody else thinks that. Every time I go to a rodeo and they get to the bull riding at the end of the rodeo, I just try to imagine, how the hell did this get started? So about 18 months ago, I think I finally landed on a likely scenario. So what I need is all of you to come with me back to the late 1800s to a roundup on a big ranch, and let's see if something like this might not have occurred. He was beginning to think, as he mixed a drink, of a way to spice things up, when a bull caught his gaze to the evening haze as he was filling his cup. As he began to wonder about that bull over yonder, in his mind he began to see a puncher or hack climbing onto his back to find out what was to be. Round the campfire that night, he thought he might introduce to the discussion of a new way to test which cowboy was best. Some thought he'd had a concussion. Most quiet at first, till a few quenched their thirst, then the question they began to attack was how long the ride once you slide onto that old monster's back. As supper was preparing, a few were raring to move this idea along, so they fashioned together some panels with leather to make a chute that was strong. With just a handle of rope, they found some dope to climb aboard the beast, then pulled the gate to determine his fate. Nothing happened, not in the least. So they fashioned some hackles around his test tackles and cinched it up good and tight. Then again pulled the chute and let out a hoot. The rider was in for a fight. From the beginning, there was bucking and spinning and fear in the cowboy's eyes. And it soon became clear, when the dirt meets the rear, that's where the real danger lies. Having seen what occurred was absolutely absurd. The talk now focused again on the ticks of the clock, once you release the stock, to determine a rider's win. So they counted to eight when they pulled the gate. Most of the riders found it was hard to get done when attempting the run before ending up on the ground. They soon had more than one that got it done once 8 seconds was spent. So they thought for a while and decided that style was important to the event. Well, next thing you know, it's part of the show at most all rodeo events. And each time we're surprised by those ill-advised who seem to have no sense. So now we find whiskey mixed up with risky behind rodeo's main event, created by one bored with an empty gourd. Now I'm pretty sure that's how it went. So now you all know what started this show of careless cowboy pursuit that has us enthralled till the rider is sprawled once they open the chute. So I was putting this set together, and Marilyn goes, "You don't have anything in there about cowgirls." And I thought, well, okay. So I said, let me see what I can come up with, and I'll give you a couple of choices, and I'll plug one of them in. And so I came back to her, and I said, I've got two options. One is a love song about a love gone bad for a cowgirl. And the other one's about a cowgirl and an outlaw. And she said, what's the name of the love song? I said, it's I hope you're living as high on the hog as the pig you turned out to be. And she said, do the ballad. From the Badlands came an outlaw, lived by the knife and the gun. He'd cut you just for standing, shoot you if you tried to run. He was big as a tree and divinity pleased, and everything he did was bad. And they said if you was to kill him, you'd only make him mad. From the good lands came a cowgirl, Patty was her name. Caught on the trail of a killer, on a moped she called Flame. 'Cause the killer killed her daddy for just spitting in the road. And you only had to kill her daddy once to get that gal PO'd. Yippee-yi-yay, Cow Patty. Yippee-yi-yay, Cow Patty. She rode in the town to find the man that killed her daddy. Yippee-yi-yay, Cow Patty. Well, the killer at town at daybreak ate the door off a local saloon. Started to drink, and folks could tell there'd be a showdown soon. Well, Patty at town in a cloud of dust, old Flame buzzing like a saw. Then the whole town got as quiet as a church when the killer stepped out for the draw. 40 shots rang out. 40 people fell. Patty and the killer missed each other. Hop! They shot that town to hell. Yippee-yi-yay, Cow Patty. Yippee-yi-yay, Cow Patty. She rode into the town to find the man that killed her daddy. Yippee-yi-yay, Cow Patty. Well, the killer took a step towards Patty, said it's time I gunned you down. Then he slipped on something that was lying in the street and shot before he hit the ground. Yeah, the killer slipped and it cost him his life. Patty said as she rode out of town, you've got to watch your step when you know the chips are down. Yippee-yi-yay, Cow Patty. Yippee-yi-yay, Cow Patty. She rode into town to find the man that killed her daddy. Yippee-yi-yay, Cow Patty.
Be careful what you wish for, Marilyn. Let me get up here. So everybody needs to have a place to go and get away to when they have when they're thinking through difficult life situations. And I need everybody over here to just hold it down just a little bit so I can think. Okay, thanks. And you know, one of those places for me was
the Texas Panhandle. And I spent a lot of time out in the Shamrock area with my rancher buddy there. And on one particular trip out there, as I pulled in the driveway, he was standing out by his truck. And he said, son, get yourself in this pickup truck and I'll treat you to a special event. I'd been behind the windshield all day, feeling about three quarters spent. We took off for his spread as the shadows stretched across the road, and he recalled a tale about the Rockin' Chair Ranch as my surroundings began to erode. the feelings that build up inside a man when he's been in the city too long. As I start to unwind, my back straightens up, feeling whipped, now coming on strong. We pull in the gate at Mill Pasture. Stay put, he says, I'll get the lock. Then he grabbed us both a cold drink, and we took a short walk. We stood there facing the western sky, the sun resting on the saddleback rim. Then the wind lay down to nothing at all. He turned, tugged his hat by the brim, and said, son, when things aren't going my way, and I think my match I've met, nothing gets me lined out and thinking straight like listening to a Texas sunset. The clouds in the sky turned from orange to pink as lower that Texas sun sank. Bob whites called from the shinry, and leopard frogs croaked in the tank. Then a coyote howled, and so did her pups. You could tell by the sound they were new. As I stood there, my troubles just melted away. What he said was all coming true. We stood there silent under that sky and watched the first star appear. Then a hoot owl called from the shelter belt, and silence was all I could hear. In a rush, it seemed, the stars filled the sky, and the starlight whispered down, just barely enough to see things in close. On the horizon, the glow of some town. I turned, put my hand on his shoulder, and said, thanks for sharing this with me, and thought of the money spent searching for peace that's available most nights for free. Then the talk turned to working and family as we headed back to the truck. He looked my way as he turned the key and said, that's my secret to getting unstuck. Though I can't always get there in person, I've relied on it many a time. When this whole world starts getting me down and I know that I'm just about prime to start to give in or run off the deep end, my friends, one thing you can bet, I'll find me a nice quiet place to hole up and listen to a Texas sunset. Another place for me, I don't know exactly why, but it's kind of a spiritual experience whenever I drive this section of road in northeast New Mexico between Clayton and Raton. I was leaving Oklahoma with the sun resting on the dash, driving hard for New Mexico, trying to outrun a past of dreams that never were fulfilled by that young man I used to be. What's done is done, like the setting sun, I guess it was meant to be. I turned north at Amarillo, left those city lights behind, not knowing where I'm going to or just what I'll find. When a voice as clear as the mountain wind found me there all alone and filled my heart on that lonely stretch between Clayton and Raton. Oh, the light of day chased the night away, bringing the mountains into view. The path my life was gonna take, up to me to choose. And on that road I traveled, the truth now plain to see. The only one that stood in the way of all my dreams was me. I pulled off to watch the sunrise and the stars fade away. I could see my life would be different in the light of a new day. And that morning sun that cleansed my soul, all my fear was gone. It happened on that lonely stretch between Clayton and Raton. And I know my life will take me back to Clayton and Raton. Thank you. So I get asked time to time, why do you think you got started on this journey? I know why I got pushed up here in front of people. It's because of my wife and people like Ryan. But why did I end up doing cowboy poetry and wanting to sing songs about the West? I think I discovered the answer to that in this next poem, and it's titled Call from the Plains. I can sense it as I stand at the edge of the breaks, look down over a mesquite-covered hill, at the way the creek winds to the bottom. This sight always brings me a thrill. And I get the feeling I belong in this place, so why don't I live out here instead of the city with a million other fools? Today, the answer came clear. I'm not a real religious man, but I know God watches over this place, and I figure he don't make many mistakes, but he might have messed up in my case. He gave me the taste for campfire smoke, wind, rain, and sun, don't you see? He must have got his eights and nines turned around when deciding when to send me. Figuring back to the beginning of time, 100 years ain't too far off course, till a man finds himself behind the wheel of a car that belongs on the back of a horse. Not much I can do but deal with it now. It's a dream I can't saddle up. Each morning starts with the only thing that fits: black coffee in a cowboy cup. On cool fall mornings when I step outdoors, days past call from the plains, of cattle drives up the Santa Fe or Chisholm. Historic markers are all that remain, of an open range air when a man with a dream could build a herd, maybe stake out a spread. Now highways and fences divide up the land, cattle truck cross country instead. So why did I end up here in the city instead of under that blue prairie sky? I search for the reasons it happened this way. You know, God's a pretty smart guy. And it suddenly occurred as I wrote down these words, maybe I was part of his plan of keeping this cowboy's spirit alive by sharing with my fellow man. Rhymes that translate visions to words, giving sight to those who've been blind, to the beauty that exists out here in the West, to the peace of mind you can find by taking the time to discover this land. Hear its thundering silence at night. Catch visions of wagon trains, Indian camps, a red-tailed hawk in flight. And who knows? It could happen to you if by chance you take a ride under the star-filled skies of the prairie at night. It could wake up the spirit inside. And you'll find yourself longing for golden grass, a swirling around in the wind, where an antelope stands at the top of a rise and a dry creek makes a bend. Where thunderstorms can blow in and darken the land in barely the blink of an eye, and sunsets that make a heart stand still, serenaded by the coyote's cry. Then you'll get the feeling I often have when surrounded by city walls, longing for the big sky country and the music of coyote calls. And from that time forward, the bright city lights will forever bring you pain once the cowboy's spirit has stolen your heart and set it free on the plain. I don't know that this song really goes with that, but I guess one of the things I get out of it is anytime I'm out on a trail ride or just out in the wild by myself, if you'll listen, you'll hear things. I've been riding fence all day, way upon the summer range. Found a place to make my bed as the evening shadows spread from beyond the campfire light to the stillness of the night and the call of the coyote quiet. And the call of the coyote. What's going on there, Ryan? Okay, it's in the call of the coyote choir. Knew no sound of the wind and the wire. As it strummed the rusted strings, sang of long forgotten things. Many moons and many suns of the first Americans, when the arrow and the bow stalked the plains for the buffalo, and the call of the coyote choir knew no sound of the wind in the wire. I'm going to move on from that. I don't like the way that's going. So as you can tell, I spent a fair amount of time thinking about and fantasizing about the cowboy life, working on a big ranch, or maybe having been involved in one of the trail drives. And I have to laugh at myself because I'm having these thoughts and ideas in an easy chair with a drink in my hand in front of the fireplace. Couldn't be any further removed from, you know, the real cowboy life. And that led to the penning of this poem called Living a Lie. He'd been living a lie, then been getting him by for almost 40 years, that his dream one day would get underway, roping and branding steers. His friends think he's crazy and probably too lazy to be making his way as a hand. But he knows in his heart that he's right for the part, and cowboy will be his last stand. Keeping this dream alive has helped him survive over several rough stretches of trail. At times he's lacked courage, let others discourage, but he's never decided to bail. Out on the notion, someday through devotion, his dedication would one day bear the fruit that he sought, not the doubts that he's fought about whether this life can be fair. Now and again, the fear sets in about whether there's still enough time. As lines appear in his reflection, it's clear he's a man that's passing his prime. He hangs on to the belief time won't be the thief that steals what he's hoping to find. Whether stubbornness or pride, he won't cast aside what's been lurking around in his mind. His vision stays clear. With each passing year, his soul hungers for his chance. But destiny must wait till he can pay the freight the piper collects for the dance. Like a debt unpaid, this promise he's made weighs heavy on his heart. So he tenders with care an occasional prayer that God will do his part. He feels some regret, watching another sunset, heaven or hell, what lies ahead. And he pours a stiff drink and tries not to think he's been hanging on by a thread. And what's kept him alive and helped him survive is the hope that one day he'll slide on the back of a roan on a place of his own, and fate will grant him his ride. So kind of along those same lines, right. This isn't cow patty. Black coffee in a cowboy cup, fall mornings when it's clear. Cowboy spirit comes calling out is when I hear. Voices of those long ago calling out my name. I remember the first time and it's never been the same. Gonna hear the coyote howling, see the hawk circle in the air, hear the thunder of the buffalo. That is when I will know that I'm there. Riding out across the plains, no sound upon the wind. I turn my spirit loose and my soul begins to mend. I ride through open country, back to a simple time, to a world that's making sense, where once again I find. Wanna hear the coyote howling, see the hawk circle in the air, hear the thunder of the buffalo. That is when I will know that I'm there. This cowboy dream of mine's been keeping me alive. I know I belong here, but in a different time. So I keep pushing on, just waiting for the call from the cowboy spirit, or I hit the wall. Wanna hear the coyote howling, see the hawk circle in the air, hear the thunder of the buffalo. That is when I will know that I'm there. So I'm down to the last poem. I'm gonna finish on a poem. I just want to thank everybody for giving me the opportunity to share, and for my sister Dottie and brother-in-law Stu and my niece Blake for coming out and support me on this. I hear some concern expressed from time to time, you know, what lies in store for the cowboy down the road. And anytime anybody asks me this, my reply is the same. What makes a cowboy will never change. Regardless of what's left of the range, the truth is it's a state of mind. If a cowboy's looking, he'll always find a place for his pony with horizon far, two-step of music in a country bar, an outdoor fire with a cooking pit, a coyote choir that just won't quit, a worn truck seat that fits just right, for watching a moon that's big and bright, a cold beer to share with a friend, a helping hand that he can lend, those tender moments that he can share with the one who handles his heart with care, the time to jot down a thoughtful note, to share with others a clever quote, the occasion to ponder what lies ahead while staring at the stars from a pickup bed, a place to hole up when the going gets tough, the courage it takes to call a bluff, a quiet spot to relax as the sun sets low and lose himself in Mother Nature's show, a red-tailed hawk a ride in the wind, a dream that allows his soul to mend, the way to keep hanging on when all seems lost, how to do what it takes and forget the cost, how to saddle back up after being thrown, a place on the prairie to call his own. The future uncertain, but continue to ride, following a path he knows will always bring pride. And if he keeps looking, he'll continue to find that being a cowboy is a state of mind. Thank you, guys. Thanks. Hey, Dot, why don't you hand that camera to somebody and the three of you come up here. What? It depends on what, huh?
Good job.
Thanks. Get this out of your way. You know what? Let me do this. Hang on a minute. Up. It is, isn't it? Okay. Okay. Okay, now we're looking at Ryan.